thinking the chi is something you talk about, Sam talks about, other people talk about, but no one really seems to know exactly how do you work on it. Are there any signs you look for to tell it, if you are actually doing something to progress in that aspect? So I was wondering if you have anything to say about that.
For me also, it was one of the, I had some questions I always used to ask in the first years. And I remember once I brought another student over there, seeing the same time for the first time. And this student heard me asking questions and thought that I was quite stupid, which might be the case, but said, how come you ask a question like that? I mean, of course you does do this. So then I said to him, well, the thing is that I've been asking the same questions over and over during the years. I don't necessarily get the same answer every time, because it's also dependent on where I am right now. And it's actually also a bit dependent on what he's focusing on right now, himself in his own practice, even though he says he doesn't practice much, in his approach to teaching as well. So these things it's different from time to time. Of course, in the first years I ask, how long should I stand? Then he told me I should stand for a certain amount of time. Then I did that. And I also brought in my bodybuilding experience, thinking, okay, if he tells me I should stand for, let's say, an hour, I go for two then. If one is good, two is double as good. Which is stupid, of course. It's not the amount of practice you spend in. You have this saying that if you do it right, 1 minute is better if you do it wrong for 1 hour. And the same goes for sinking the chi. When I ask him again and again, well, what is sinking the chi? How do you sink the chi? Then he tried to explain it different ways and so on, and you can touch him, of course, and I could feel in his body that he was definitely doing reverse breathing, he was expanding and things like that, but still I thought he had something up the sleeve, until one night he was basically throwing me around in his underwear. So I mean, unless his mind that he has something that he says, that just like, you know, when you see this magician's abracadabra or something like that. And then it's a new ball game I didn't know about, that it actually works. But I don't think he's doing that. Does it have to do with his mind? It definitely has to do with his mind. You have to think of a thing that is people don't like to think about too much. Is that time is a factor. Not just timing. Timing is a factor. But time is a factor. Under the right teaching, under the right conditions, with the with not just an empty cup, but with something that's actually something in it, then progression takes place year by year. And some of the old masters, if you ask them 60 years down the road, how do I learn to sink the tea? They might even know it, don't know it themselves anymore, because it's just an integrated part. That's also why I very often say, if I was to pick a teacher, because I sometimes hear some well-known teachers say that, well, I learned from this master in his latest part of his life, so I got the best thing and so on. I don't think so. You got what he was working at that point. Then again, you can have somebody who learned in the early period, unless they're already dead. And this is not the greatest part, time to be there either. If I was to pick, I would definitely be there two-thirds into this exceptional, good, skillful guy's own learning process. Because they can still sort of look back, remember what they did, and they're still developing. Getting there when they are 80 or 90 and they can't really remember what they did anymore because it's so integrated, difficult to pick it up. And singing the chi has to do with breathing, but it's not a secret breathing. Singing has to do with relaxing the muscles, but it's not floppy, it's not collapsing. Singing the chi has to do with expanding. Thinking the chi has to do with your mind. And there are other parts in it as well, but it's just it's an abstract information right now. You have to touch also to get an idea of what it is. And then you work with the things, start seeing some small results from it. Then you start being capable of repeating something. Then you start being capable of repeating it more often, not only one out of 20 and so on. So it's a quite abstract things actually. And it's not because I don't want to explain it. It's not because I can't explain it, but you have to have the sense feeling also. You have to feel it to get an idea of what to work on. And then you've got to accept that it takes time to do it. And I see people who say, yeah, if you can't explain it well, then you don't know what it is. I also see people who said, yeah, I can explain it, but it's only for my indoor students. And you know, all this kind of thing. Mm. But it tells me it's normally just they don't know it. Don't have any clue of it, but they don't want to be found out.